Happy April Fool's Day, everybody. Xavier back again with another video. Welcome to my first Throwback Thursday Attitude Era rant of April. As you can see on my shirt, today has been 20 years since WrestleMania 17 not only aired on pay-per-view, but was here in Houston, Texas at the old Astrodome. I can't believe it's been 20 years since WrestleMania 17 came to this city. We definitely had a great time watching this pay-per-view when it aired. And everybody that was at the Houston Astrodome had a good time when it was at that Houston Astrodome. This was also the first WrestleMania pay-per-view that came to Texas. So before I show y'all the highlights of WrestleMania 17, I'm going to tell y'all all the matches. I know all the matches by heart without looking in my notebook. And I got another Attitude Era rant for this April Fool's Day after this. But first, this is highlights from WrestleMania 17. Mind you, we have a lot of deceased wrestlers on this card. So whenever I say the late wrestler's name, that means that wrestler is no longer with us. The first match was the pre-show that was on Sunday Night Heat on MTV. A tag team match between the X-Factor, X-Pac and Justin Credible versus the Lethal Weapon Steve Blackman and the late Grandmaster Sexay. The winners were the X-Factor, Justin Credible and X-Pac. Now, the first WrestleMania 17 match was an Intercontinental Championship match. William Regal versus Chris Jericho. A six-man tag team match. Taz and the APA versus the Right to Censor. A triple threat match for the Hardcore Championship. Kane versus Raven versus Paul White. A European Championship match. The late Test versus the late Eddie Guerrero. Kurt Angle versus the late Chris Benoit. A Women's Championship match. The late Chyna versus Ivory. This was one of my favorite matches. Father and Son Street Fight. Vince McMahon versus Shane McMahon. This is another one of my favorite matches. A second WrestleMania TLC match for the Tag Team Championship. The Hardy Boys versus the Dudley Boys versus Edge and Christian. Why I call it a second WrestleMania TLC match? Because their first WrestleMania TLC match was at WrestleMania 2000. That's one of my Flashback Friday Attitude Era rants for tomorrow. Highlights of WrestleMania 2000. Next match, the Gimmick Battle Royal. Another one of my favorite matches, Triple H versus The Undertaker. And on my shirt, my favorite match of WrestleMania 17, the main event. A second WrestleMania no disqualification match for the WWF Championship. My two favorite wrestlers from my childhood, who I call the Tupac and Biggie of professional wrestling. The toughest SOB of the WWE, the Bionic Redneck, the host of Straight Up Steve Austin on the USA Network, the host of Broken Skull Sessions, the Texas Rattlesnake, and WWE Hall of Famer, Stone Cold Steve Austin, versus the most electrifying man in sports and entertainment, the great one, the Brahma Bull, the people's champ, The Rock. And people say that this was the end of the Attitude Era. I can respect those who say that, but to me, the Attitude Era pretty much ended after WrestleMania 18. But for those that said that the Attitude Era ended after WrestleMania 17, I won't disagree with you or disrespect your opinion. But to me, the Attitude Era pretty much ended in 2002 when they got rid of the WWF logo. And let me know in the comments down below, did Stone Cold Steve Austin break your heart when he turned heel that night at WrestleMania 17, allying with Vince McMahon? Without further ado, here's the highlights from WrestleMania 17. I definitely like the soundtrack to this pay-per-view. live from Houston, Texas. Here we go, the main event. That's the highlights of WrestleMania 17. I'll be back with my second Attitude Era rant after I upload this. Reminiscing 19 years of Stone Cold Steve Austin signing a contract to go to Raw or SmackDown from the April Fool's Day 2002 edition of Monday Night Raw. If you smell what The Rock is cooking. And that's the bottom line. 'Cause Stone Cold said so.